Assalamu alaikum. Today we will talk about the enzyme as a possible target for drugs. وطبعاً, if you remember, we were talking about the receptor as one of our drug targets in the last chapter. وطبعاً بنعرف إحنا إنه الريسبتورز and the enzymes, they are proteins, they are polypeptides. وحكينا في عنا يعني structural similarities between the receptors and the enzymes ومع هيك في عنا some major differences between the action of the receptor and the enzyme. فin general the enzymes are proteins طبعا with generally a well defined and اللي هو three dimensional structure وكل enzyme it has a characteristic 3D structure compared to other enzymes وحكينا إحنا إنه الإنزيم بشكل عام هو عبارة عن soluble protein وطبعا هاي النقطة لما إحنا فرقنا بين البروتين سوري الإنزيم و الريسبتر الريسبتر بشكل عام هو membrane bound receptor أو membrane bound protein فهو في معظم الحالات أو معظم أنواع الريسبترز they are bounded or integrated into the membrane while the enzyme in general it is soluble enzyme في عنا بعض أنواع الإنزيمز بتكون bounded to certain types of receptors such as tyrosine kinase حكينا إنه في بعض أنواع التيروسين كينيز بتكون مربوطة بال EGFR اللي هو الإبيديرمال جروث فاكتور ريسبتر فإن جنرال المهم إنه الإنزيمز they are soluble لما نحكي soluble يعني بنحكي عن طبعا suspended in solution طبعا solution means بنحكي عن either intracellularly or extracellular فإن جنرال هذا بيخلي الايزوليشن اوف انزيم از ماتش ايزير ذان ذا ايزوليشن اوف ريسبتر ولما انا احكي عن ايزوليشن اوف انزيم فروم انسايد ذا سيل اور فروم ذا اكستراستيشيال فلويد سو ات از ماتش ايزي تو كاركترايز او تو ستدي ذا ستراكشر اوف ذا انزيم بيكوز اوف ذات So many 3D structures of enzymes have been solved and saved inside the protein data bank. So it is very easy to study the structure of enzyme, the structure of the active site found inside the enzyme in order to design new drugs or new, for example, inhibitors for this particular enzyme. طيب زي ما احنا شايفين هون انه الانزيم it has a definite binding site called the active site or the binding site and in some cases it is called the catalytic site or catalytic domain اللي هو the small area found inside the structure of the enzyme that is responsible for the catalysis of the reaction or the activation of the reaction found inside the body. فهنا بنلاحظ انه السبستريت will come and bind to the binding site or the active site. بعدين شو بصير عندي؟ The substrate will be converted into products. بينما هذا الإشي ما كنا نشوفه بالريسبتر because the ligand will bind to the receptor, then the this binding will result in a response or will result in a conformational change that will activate signal transduction. Okay? فإذا بالنهاية إنه السبستريت will be converted into metabolites or into products, وهاي البرودكتس could bind later to a receptor and it will induce a response at the end. Okay? طيب. طبعا as we can see here, this is the structure of proteins, 3D structure of proteins. وطبعا هنا بنلاحظ احنا انه ال substrate it has specific binding site inside the protein structure. وهي ال 3D structure it's very easy to study by using special types of softwares in order to see or to visualize the 3D structure of a given a protein or enzyme. طيب طبعا الانزيم احنا حكينا هو it is a macromolecule or it is a protein that will catalyze a chemical reaction. طبعا لما نحكي عن catalyze it will accelerate a chemical reaction inside our body. And believe it or not, if the reaction X for example, إذا في عندي هنا reaction, let's say hydrolysis, I will start this reaction in the lab, in the laboratory. And if my body will hydrolyze, for example, an ester, so the reaction rate inside the body might be 10 to the power 14, the reaction rate in the lab. So what does this mean? This means that the enzyme will catalyze the reaction in a very rapid rate compared to the reaction inside the lab. Okay. طبعا هنا هي بس عبارة عن مقارنة. It's just a comparison about the endothermic reactions. And as we know, in most of the reactions, we have to increase or heat the reaction for catalysis or to accelerate a given reaction. So sometimes if you want to accelerate a chemical reaction in the lab, so simply we can heat the reaction flask or we can stir. So by stirring, we will increase the will increase the entropy or the randomness of molecules because the collision will increase or will improve the interaction between the reactants molecules. So the third possible way of accelerate a given reaction is by adding a catalyst. And here we are talking about acid, for example, base catalyzed reaction. We can add metal as a catalyst and so many types of catalyzing agents. And we can do another thing is by the removal of products once it formed, because if you are going to remove the products, and we are talking about reversible reaction, so product 1 plus product 2, So if there is a possibility of removing one of the product, so definitely the reaction will go forward in order to synthesize additional product one, and so on. This is what is called the Le-Chatelier principle of the enzyme equilibria. So as we can see here, the four possible ways of increasing the rate of the reaction in the lab. So what about inside our body? So there is no possibility of increasing the temperature, because the temperature of our body, it's around 37 point something. Stirring, you can't stir the body in order to improve the collision between molecules. The catalyst, here we don't add catalyst to the body. Instead, we have our own catalysts inside the body. We have what is called coenzymes. We have enzymes. These molecules will act as a catalyst for the enzyme to take place. Removal of product, we cannot remove product, but our body might remove the product once it formed. Why? By continuous washing of the body compartments, by filtration, by blood flow. So this might be applied inside our body. Okay. So this is another example of reaction, and this reaction takes place in four steps. This reaction is acid catalyzed hydrolysis, and believe it or not, inside our body, it might take a lesser time by 10 to the power 10. So it will take very short time to take place, this type of reactions. Okay, so as we said in the beginning of this lecture, all enzymes have a specific active site. وطبعا specific active site أو اللي هي بيسموها very small area of enzyme. طبعا هاي small area of enzyme في معظم الكتب بنسميها الactive site أو binding site أو بنسميها catalytic domain. It is a very small area of the enzyme, and mainly it is found deep inside the protein structure. Okay. طبعا هذا ال binding site أو ال small area, it might have around 20 amino acids, 30 amino acids. So it depends on the size of the whole protein. But not all available amino acids inside the active site will take part in the enzyme catalysis. Because of that, we can classify the amino acids found inside the active site into two types. One is called the catalytic amino acids, and the other one is the non-catalytic amino acid. The catalytic amino acid will take part in the enzyme catalysis, while the non-catalytic will just help shaping the active site of the enzyme,
and the tunnels or the openings that will lead to the active site. طبعاً, because we are talking about amino acids, we should memorize the structure of all amino acids available inside the proteins and what are the chemical or the physicochemical properties of these amino acids. So as we can see here, we have some non-polar amino acids such as alanine, valine, leucine, isoleucine, phenylalanine, proline. We have some polar amino acids such as the serine and threonine. We have some aromatic such as tyrosine and phenylalanine as well. We have some polar amino acids with amide functionality such as the asparagine and the glutamine. We have acidic amino acids, زي الاسبارتيك acid, glutamic acid. And we have some amino acids with basic characteristic features such as the lysine, arginine, and histidine. So if these amino acids found inside the active site, you should know what you expect from these amino acids to form possible bonds with your drug. طيب, according to the reaction, enzymes can be classified according to the function. So for example, oxidoreductase, these enzymes will catalyze the oxidation reduction. Hydrolase, these enzymes will hydrolyze, for example, esters, will hydrolyze amide and so on. Lyase, they will catalyze the elimination reaction of C double bond C or C double bond N. Isomerase, responsible for the isomerization for alkenes, and the stereogenic centers such as R to S or S to R and so on. So we have so many types of enzymes that are classified according to the function أو according to الوظيفة تبعت كل إنزيم. So reductase معناها reduction. Oxidase معناها oxidation. Monooxygenase معناها إضافة one oxygen atom and so on. Okay؟ طيب. هسا بالنسبة للميكانيزم of binding, إحنا بنعرف إنه في عندي two major mechanism of binding. أول واحدة اللي هي أثبتت فشلها اللي هي look and key model or look and key theory. طبعا look and key means for each enzyme we have only one substrate. زيها زي الكي واللوك. For each look we have only one key. You can't find two keys that will able to open a one look. طبعا هاي النظرية أثبتت فشلها because more than one drug can bind to the same enzyme, can inhibit the same enzyme. إذن النظرية هاي مش صحيحة. النظرية الأدق اللي هي induced fit theory. وزي ما احنا شايفين بالستركتشر, the substrate is in rectangle structure. شايفين هنا؟ طبعاً upon binding between the substrate and the active site, a conformational change will happen to both of them. طبعاً, at least the conformation will happen to the active site. But it might happen to both of them. بعدين, لما يصير عندي conformational change للactive site وللsubstrate, the reaction will take place in order to produce products. فهذا بنسميها الانديوست فيت ثيوري, وهذا اكبر دليل على انه اكثر من مركب باختلاف الاستراكشر تبعهم كان بايند اند كان فيت تو ذا سيم بايندينج سايت. طيب هسه البايندينج فور دراجز مايت اكر نوت تو ذا اكتيف سايت, ات مايت هابن تو ا بايندينج سايت far from the active site is called the allosteric site. والallosteric site عادة وين بكون؟ هو عبارة عن binding site تقريبا بيكون على surface of the protein. شايفين هنا؟ This is the allosteric site. It is far from the binding site of the substrate. But what will happen if your drug binds the allosteric site? It will induce a conformational change to the binding site or the active site. رح يغير الشكل الـ active site, and in this case, this active site will not be suitable for binding the substrate. وبهاي الحالة رح أنا أعمل inhibition تقريبا للـ enzyme action. وهذا هو مبدأ اللي هو الـ feedback inhibition of the biological pathways inside our body. وطبعا في عنا another mechanism for regulating the action of the enzyme اللي هي عن طريق اللي هي الفوسفوريليشن. في عنا بعض الانزيمز if it's not phosphorylated it is in the resting mode. إذن هذا الانزيم بيعتمد على الفوسفوريليشن بإضافة فوسفيت جروب عشان يصير له activation. أوكي؟ طيب وفي عنا كمان بعض الانزيمز بتكون على شكل برو انزيمز, وهاي الانزيمز must be activated and converted into the active form in order to be active and catalyze a chemical reaction. ما تركزوش عليهم. خلينا نحكي عن الانزيم انهبيترز. الانزيم انهبيترز يا اما يكون ارتباطهم ريفرسيبل يا اما يكون ارتباطهم ريفرسيبل. And let's start with the reversible inhibitors. الريفرسيبل انهبيترز we have three possible mechanisms. يا اما دواي بيرتبط كومبيتيتيفلي, اذا بهاي الحاله مركبي راح يرتبط وين؟ راح يرتبط على البايندينج سايت اوف ذا سبستريت. It will compete with the substrate on the same binding site. بينما non-competitive هذا المركب مين اللي راح يرتبط وين؟ على الallosteric site. وفي عندي مركب أو inhibitor بنسميهم uncompetitive inhibitors, وهذولا راح يرتبطوا على الانزيم substrate complex, وراح نحكي عن الحكي هذا بعد شوي. طيب competitive inhibitor اذا مركبي will compete the substrate on the same binding site. وبهاي الحاله عشان مركبي يعمل competitive inhibition it must mimic the structure of the substrate. فاذا انا بدي مركبي يرتبط اذا انا بدي اخليه يشبه substrate من ناحيه الشكل. في معظم الحالات my inhibitor will mimic the transition state of the substrate. لأنه في معظم الميكانيزمز of enzyme substrate interaction اللي بيرتبط بالإنزيم active site بشكل أقوى هو the transition state of the substrate rather than the substrate itself. خلينا نأخذ مثال كوفورمايسين. طبعا كوفورمايسين it's one of the anti-neoplastic drug, وبنلاحظ احنا انه الـ AMP بيرتبط بالـ deaminase enzyme وبعطيني the alcohol intermediate this compound. فإذا أنا rather than instead of designing my drug to mimic the structure of AMP I will design my drug to mimic the structure of the intermediate. ليش؟ لأنه هذا الانترميديت ارتباطه أقوى بالبايندينج سايت. فعشان هيك الكوفورمايسين زي ما بنلاحظ في الشجر مويتي زيه زي الانترميديت, وفي النيتروجين بيس لايك ستراكشر, وانستيد اوف ذا امينو في عندي الاو اتش جروب which resemble the structure of the intermediate. Another example of this type of inhibitors اللي هم الامتنب. الامتنب هذا المركب it mimic the structure of the ATP which is the natural substrate for tyrosine kinase. وبهاي الحالة مركبي راح يكون ارتباطه effectively. وهون احنا شايفين الجليفاك اللي هو الامتنب مرتبط مكان الATP. فإذا in general your inhibitor might resemble the structure of the substrate or it might resemble the structure of the coenzyme of this substrate. يعني بحالة التيروسين كينيز
احنا صنعنا الامتنب to mimic the structure of ATP. It is the coenzyme. It's not the substrate for the tyrosine kinase. وهذا المثال بس او السلايد بيبين كيف احنا ممكن نعمل modification for a given drug in order to strongly resemble the transition state or strongly resemble the the coenzyme or the substrate structure. وبهاي الحالة ارتباطه راح يكون أقوى وبكون potent inhibitor. فمثلا هنا إضافة البنزاميد group has improved the activity against tyrosine. إضافة البايبرازين ring has improved the water solubility and the oral availability. بينما إضافة البايريدين has improved the activity بالcellular level. Okay. بالنسبة للnon-competitive inhibitor احنا حكينا هاي المركبات بترتبط على الallosteric site. إذن منطقيا هذا الstructure تبع هاي المركبات راح يكون بعيد عن الstructure تبع substrate, راح يكون مختلف. فمثلا الريفامبيسين أو الريفامبين it will allosterically inhibit the RNA polymerase of the bacteria. وفي عندنا كثير أمثلة على non-competitive inhibitor. فمثلا النيفيرابين أكيد سمعنا فيه. النيفيرابين هو مركب antiviral. طبعا النيفيرابين it is a non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. It is non-nucleoside. فإذا هو ما بيشبه الناتشرال سبستريت تبع الريفيرس الترانسكريبتيز الفيرال ريفيرس ترانسكريبتيز. إذن definitely it is a non-competitive inhibitor for this enzyme. فهذا كمان another example for. وآخر إشي بدنا نحكي عن uncompetitive inhibitor. هذول المركبات will wait until the substrate bind with your enzyme, then they will bind with the enzyme substrate complex. وفي عنا معظم الانتيكانسر drugs والtopoisomerase inhibitors هم من هذا النوع. They will wait until the topoisomerase bind the DNA, and then this shape, the new shape of this complex will be suitable for binding your drug. مثلا التوبوتيكان, ايرينوتيكان, التوبوسايد, هذول كلهم مركبات بنسميهم uncompetitive inhibitor. يعني باختصار شديد هم راح يستنوا. مثلا هنا في عندي البايندينج سايت اوف يور اوف ذا انزايم, وهنا في عندي ارتبط عندي the natural substrate, then my drug will bind after that to this complex. So they will not bind the empty enzyme. Instead, they will wait until your enzyme binding with the natural substrate. Okay? آخر إشي اللي هو irreversible. وبلما نحكي عن irreversible inhibitors هذولا راح يعملوا covalent bond with the binding site. In general, عشان مركبك يرتبط irreversibly لازم يكون electrophile while the enzyme will act as the nucleophile. فنأخذ مثال الأسبرين will bind irreversibly to the cyclooxygenase enzyme. زي ما بنلاحظ الإستر جروب في هذا الموقع راح تعمل كوفيلنت بوند مع السيرين أمينو أسيد اللي موجود بالبايندينج سايت. بنسلين جي نفس الفكرة, والأورليستات which is anti أو hypolipidemic drug because of this unstable ring زيها زي اللاكتام رينج مركبي it is highly electrophilic.